Hi, hello. Can you hear me all right? Excellent.
Turn my mic on here. Okay, there. For the stream, I did not have my mic enabled.
Oops.
Yep. It is corrected.
Okay, give me 1 second. Ellie, could you do mommy a favor? Could you shut the door, please? Your sissy's upset, and yeah, my youngest is having a hard time this evening.
No
So,
worries.
thank you. She it's kind of a funny story. I have like crazy trypophobia, and she's playing with a Play-Doh. And she has some little thing, and she had a Play-Doh pancake and poked a whole bunch of random holes in it and wanted to show it to me because it's supposed to be her Swiss cheese. Well, I was proud of myself because I actually held out for several showings of this fearsome little thing. And finally, I was like, Mom, can you get her to keep this at the kitchen table where Play-Doh is supposed to stay anyway? Because it's getting to me now. And my mom misunderstood and thought that I was wanting to see if she could convince her to make something different with this one pancake of Play-Doh. So she did, and the bomb dropped, and my child has been absolutely hysterical since her grandmother destroyed this holy pancake that she was so proud of. And I got her calmed down for a second, and I don't know what she's screaming about right now, but her nana's got her, so she'll be right as rain in a minute because nanas are awesome like that. But she was devastated. Oh my God. I've never seen her that upset. I mean, she's not even 3 years old yet, but oh my Lord. Her feelings were so hurt, and she was angry at the same time. And I was like, well, here you go, love. You get to experience the full gamut of negative emotions in one sitting.
Man, that's rough.
I know.
Especially at a young age when you're not equipped to deal with that.
Exactly. She's going through the terrible twos thing too. So, she's already at a in a situation where, I mean, not only is her mind too young to really deal with it, she's already frustrated because she can't do the things that her brain wants her to do yet. Her body can't do these things. So she has that frustration, and now this on top of it, and it's just like, oh my gosh. It's just like a shrieking household. She seems contented now though, from what I can see. Oh, wow. Didn't think I was ever going to get her settled down. I mean, she was It was really like almost scary how upset she was. And at the time, I mean, I was just like, oh my God, is this my child? And I have to laugh about it now because it was so shocking. It's like, oh boy.
Okay. Looks like we got someone else joining in.
Hello.
Howdy.
Hey, there you are.
Yo, yo, yo.
Yo, what up?
Yeah, or just hi. I don't know.
Either or.
Yeah, whichever works. We ready to get the show on the road, or?
I'm mostly ready.
Okie dokie.
I'm just going over some last minute preparation stuff, trying to figure out if I should give you guys some side missions ahead of time, to get you leveled up and a little bit more prepared for the beginning, or just drop you in like the thing suggests? But knowing the way I GM, that would cause an instant TPK.
I vote for side missions then.
Yeah, the very first encounter is a CR5.
Yeah, I vote side missions.
Yeah. For a bunch of level ones, even at heroic, I think a CR5 might be a little above your ability.
Yeah.
With a party of three, maybe four, depending on whether or not Savage gets in time. We're going to let him get here before that for sure, so it'd be four.
Oh, yeah,
but
yeah, of course.
Still.
It might actually be... I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
No problem.
It might actually be a good thing that he's running a little bit late, because, like I said, I'm so terribly unprepared, and I'm so sorry, because I do take this very seriously. I've just got issues.
Hey, don't apologize. This is fun. This is supposed to be fun.
Yes.
Well, I know, and I totally get that. Absolutely. I mean, that's why I'm here. I just...
First session always starts rocky. Always.
Yeah.
I just want to let you know that, you know, I respect the effort and time that you've put into it.
Oh, hell yeah.
I just have my own weird stuff going on, and...
We all got weird stuff going on, believe me. I gotta deal with this cold Canada weather. Ugh.
Oh, yuck. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, it's not fun.
No, I imagine not.
Yeah.
Another friend of mine is up there dealing with that weather. He accidentally left his window open when he left for work and came back to it being completely frozen open.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Wow.
That'll do it.
Furtive, that was actually Thomas.
Yeah, I figured. But
yeah.
I hadn't heard that yet.
Yeah, he came home and his window was frozen open, and he's like, I'm going to freeze to death tonight. And I'm like, no, you won't. So, do you have a hair dryer? Go get a hair dryer. If your mom has a hair dryer, you could use that. That's what we have to use to defrost our ice maker, because it freezes up every once in a while. Because we're straight up ghetto. And, you know.
Ghetto.
All right. Yep. If you jump on my Twitch, you would be able to see the background scrolling through. These are actually backgrounds relative to Sandpoint. Ha! Different game. Riddleport.
That's Jade Regent, buddy.
Dimensions are melding!
Yeah, well, Sandpoint's in a few of the different APs. So.
Oh, snap. Hang on. I gotta get Roll 20 up.
Fun fact, actually, the PC I'm running and her entire family are from Sandpoint originally.
Oh.
Or at least the general area.
Okay.
Yeah. We started with the Jade Regent Adventure Path, so I was like, they all got to be there.
Nice. Yeah, Rise of the Rune Lords also takes place primarily in and around Sandpoint.
Nice.
And what Jade Regent kind of picks up right after the events of Rise of the Rune Lords. Like, there's a little bit of a gap, but not much. Maybe a year or two at max.
That's cool.
Yeah.
So it still does it still have like a primarily Far Eastern feel?
No, Rise of the Rune Lords is totally different in all senses than Jade Regent.
Gentlemen, I'm sorry to interrupt. I actually have to step away for a moment to see if I can calm my daughter down. I'll be right back.
Totally fine. I don't know where Sis is at yet.
Yeah, I don't know. Says she's here, but...
Hello.
Hey.
Howdy. Oh, there. Jesus Christ.
It startled me.
Sneaky Sis is sneaky.
Well done.
No, I was adjusting my microphone. I'm so sorry. Holy
shit. That's all right.
I didn't even see you enter. Oh, there you are over there. Yeah, your image is blank for me, so I didn't see it. Wow.
Oh, Jesus. Okay.
There it is.
Sorry.
There.
Oh,
okay.
Okay. There you go. Hello.
Howdy.
Hello. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and turn on the PC slides. Okay.
Doki.
So now, in the stream that... be showing your characters. as well.
Where is it?
Okay. I don't know if I'm in the correct streamy stream.
It's just Twitch / QT Purdue.
Yeah, I just don't know if I went to the right Twitch placey place. Might have clicked on someone else's.
Oh.
Oh, look at us. You're so tiny.
Yeah, we so tiny.
You're so gray.
What? Yeah, you lack of color?
Well, part of that's...
gray and tiny.
Part of that's on, you know, purpose, because then you can describe in character the colors and stuff, and then if anyone wants to do art, we can switch out those images later or leave them as is, and you can do your own things with art or whatever. I just wanted to put something together for this first stream.
Good. Okay. Yeah, it works.
Yeah, I thought about coloring it in myself, but I only had...
That's a lot of work.
Yeah, I only had a little bit of time to get this done, so...
Did you only have, like, what, the whole world to make?
Or yeah.
create?
That's true.
Yeah, I only entered in, like, 60 pages or in whatever into Obsidian Portal for you guys. No big deal.
Mm-hmm.
Which, probably none of you have read any of it, so...
I did check out some of the wiki pages, actually.
Oh, look at my tiny little badass. Yeah.
Yeah, the Riddleport wiki page is linked off to all the major areas, which are also on the map of Riddleport that's on Obsidian Portal. It's got those numbers there. The numbers for the regions correspond to their wiki. Like, if you search Riddleport and then the number, it'll be that same area.
Right.
And that's mostly... near verbatim what I would read out of the book to you in describing the different areas.
Okay.
I did a little bit of GM editing, but...
Well, at least you didn't type everything.
Yeah, seriously, thank you for that. Totally forgot I had the PDF and I could copy and paste.
You're welcome. I was wondering... Jesus, never mind.
It was taking me forever.
Anything so you don't have to do all the work ever.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's a lot of work. And we're, what, like 5? 6? So, time crunch.
1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 5, I think. 5 of us, I believe.
There's
my math is correct.
4 players.
4 players plus you, so 5.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, 5. But I'm the GM, so I don't need anything for me, per se.
Yeah, but... You're included, don't worry.
I don't need to be included.
So far, we have a crisis averted.
Well, good job.
Yay.
Yay, mother good.
All the Play-Doh.
All the Play-Doh. Oh, God.
All the Play-Doh. Jesus.
I told Fern of the story about the
trilogy
and the Play-Doh.
Oh, my God.
Ugh. What happened was, sis, my I was able to handle a few showings of it, and then my nurse just couldn't take it anymore. So, I walked her into the kitchen and told my mom that it was getting to me, and asked her if she could just make sure that Bella kept the Play-Doh at the table like she's supposed to.
Mm-hmm.
Or Bella, not my mom. Well, anyway, you know what I mean.
Right.
Well, my mom, for some reason, thought, I guess,
that
I was
okay
asking
with it?
Her. No, I think she thought that I meant make that holy pancake into something different.
Oh, Jesus. Okay.
So she did, and there was a complete and total hysterical meltdown on the part of my toddler.
Oops.
Oh.
Yeah. Because, you know, she was so proud of her little freaky pancake.
Right. Thing. With Smarties.
Yeah, exactly. And oh my god. Finally I got her to try something new and make another one with different shaped holes. It's So the abomination is in there on the table. I'm just trying to avoid it.
Affirmative.
So.
Just so I can say, I'm so glad you didn't include the leadership feat, because that can open up like so many cans of worms.
Yes. Yes. The leadership feat is banned for good reason.
Yeah, it's insane.
What does the leadership feat
do? What does it do?
It allows you to gain Skyrim style.
Jesus.
Yeah, well, not only just one follower. At higher levels, you can have an entire entourage of like 50 or more.
Oh, Jesus. Bad blood.
Yeah,
basically.
Yeah,
it's actually really funny. Oh, sorry.
It doesn't overbalance anything. It floods the area with so much to do, and it puts so much weight on that player and or the GM, or both, depending on how it's being ran. That it's just a nightmare, and it drags the entire game to a crawl.
Oh. God damn it, Lydia. Stop running off.
Okay. So you've all familiarized yourself with Riddleport, correct?
Yes. A little bit. I was able to sit down and flip through a lot of it. Like, I learned about the cipher?
Mm-hmm. The cipher gate?
Yes, the cipher gate and the occult. The cult associated with it.
Okay.
And I started reading about Lavender Lil and how cool she is.
Yes.
She is what we refer to around here as a bad bitch.
In your native parlance.
In my native parlance, exactly. The tongue of my people.
This is what we call in homeland a badass beach.
Bad beach.
I'm so sorry.
In Mother Russia.
In Mother Russia.
This is known as a bad beach. Bad beach.
silly people with your dialects.
Okay. So to start out, I know Savage isn't here yet, but go ahead and introduce your characters, give a little brief history on your character, like their backstory, but only what somebody who has come across them would be able to tell. Like, if I was asking about you to somebody else in the city, what would they be able to tell me? So give us that kind of background on your character, brief description of appearance, like first impression type stuff, and that will get us into also what you're doing here and what you're looking to go about doing in Riddleport during your stay, etc. And whether or not you even know each other, because I'm not aware if you do yet.
Okay.
Who's first?
Whoever has the most solid backstory, I guess, should go first. I know, right?
I don't know if it's 100% solid, because I've actually been working on it in my spare time, but I don't really know much about the... Like, I know a bit about my character's family and stuff, but...
Well, I think right now, basically, what we're looking for is just essentially what are we doing here in Riddleport. Like, not what's okay. Like, for example, are you doing work in Riddleport? You know, if you went into Riddleport and you asked somebody on the street, hey, that person over there, what do they do? Who are they? Basically, we're looking for what that person would tell you.
Exactly.
Okay, well, I'll go ahead and start. I am Zanya. And for the most part, you would understand that I am a fortune teller.
That's funny, actually.
Ooh.
I spend my evenings at local eating or drinking establishments across this filthy place. Doing my best to earn some coin. Telling the fortunes of the greedy or the deeply confused or even the pitifully desperate.
The deeply confused.
The troubled.
So basically what you're saying is the generally stupid.
One might say that.
Let's not sugarcoat it here.
Yeah.
Well, I wanted my profession tries to be a little bit more diplomatic. Yes?
Yeah, I suppose.
And yet, alas, that is the most depth that you would get.
You know what, Zanya, was it? You remind me so much of a very, very close friend of mine. Actually, she's my sister, but technically also a friend.
Well, then one would hope that you are indeed close friends, yes.
Yes, well, as close as one could possibly get, really. You can call me, my full name is Diamita, but you can call me Dia. All my friends do. Or whoever I call friend, at least. As the Lady Zanya has alluded to, I'm not a fortune teller myself, but I do know one, as my dearest twin sister is in fact a fortune teller as well. I, however, you could say I'm not much of a fortune teller at all. I'm more of a, you could say, hired arm, perhaps. If anyone needs someone to do a little how are we gonna put this? Physical diplomacy, if you know what I mean. Then they tend to call me, which is a little bit weird because, as you can probably guess from the way I am, I'm a halfling, about 3 feet. You might not have noticed any particular stature from me, but I can assure you the fact that I am probably half your size won't mean a lick of difference if I'm pummeling your face in. Which I have been known to do. Normally, as most people are probably doing, I can also be found at a tavern or eatery or some other establishment, probably having a drink or challenging someone to an arm wrestle or something like that. I don't know. Just whatever strikes my fancy. And if you put enough coin in front of me, and tell me to go punch something, I'll go punch it. Sometimes multiple times. I like punching things. It's my job. And one more thing. Don't call me short. Please. Just please. I don't want to knock your teeth out as well. Right, well, I could give you a physical description as well, if you wish.
If you feel it's necessary, sure.
Well, all right. Dia is about, like I said, about 3 feet. As I said before, she's a halfling, so she's not very... She's kind of slight of build, but unlike most of her race, you could say, she's... rather heavily built. She's got quite a bit of muscle. Short and stocky, basically. A little lean. Like, she's not, like, built like a football player, per se. She's got, like, probably what you would call, like, a gymnast build.
Oh, okay.
So, very lean.
So not stocky at all, then.
Not stocky, but like lithe and, but has bulk to her though, like mm-hmm. not like, yeah. She normally she has very long, sort of reddish brown hair.
She's got those gymnast thighs.
She's got them gymnast thighs, yes. she's got very long reddish brown hair that extends to about her mid to lower back, usually done up in a ponytail. And another thing that can that clues to you that she's probably not from around here is she doesn't wear a whole lot. She's typically seen with like rather like baggy harem pants and not much of a top, really. She's kind of got those weird loopy. I don't know how you'd even describe it. It's like one of those. It's not a straight like a bikini or anything, but it's like one of those. It's not.
It's like a chest wrap. Perhaps?
It's like a chest wrap, basically. Yeah.
That just covers the boobage.
Covers the boobage. Yeah, basically.
But yeah, I completely forgot to add it. Add in a description of my character. My
bad. That's fine. That's okay. That's But other than that, you know, that's. I mean, occasionally she'll be wearing a black eye or, you know, something like that.
Oh, Lord.
Because she likes to fight. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. She likes to fight. But she has a rather odd fighting style, which doesn't just wound, but also seems to almost disalign your ties to some sort of power, perhaps, and can lead you to be somewhat clumsier than usual for some reason, which you will very quickly find out should we ever get into combat.
She will Bruce Lee your butt on a metaphysical level, huh?
Yeah, she'll definitely. Yeah, she has a very. I took a an archetype known as
I mean, mentioned before. Basically, my blonde waifu right now is just like slowly backing away. Like I'm. I'm gonna.
Yeah, you've got heavy armor. Right, you're fine with like your. I mean. To be perfectly honest, Dia's probably going to get beat up a lot, and I'm assuming you've got some sort of healing, considering.
Definitely.
So she might actually might actually approach you every now and then, just so she can be like, "Hey, I got a bit of a broken arm. You think you can heal that? Yeah, thanks."
Sure.
A bit of a broken arm.
Yeah, that's typically how she would phrase it too. Like, my arm's kind of sort of broken. You think you can, you know, use your little oogity boogity and there you go.
She's a feisty scrapper. I love it already.
She's a tiny feisty scrapper. She's a little halfling pit bull. And I mean that in every sense of the word.
It's adorable.
Adorable. I tried to go for like the total tomboy.
Awesome.
Yeah.
See, I picture as having, you know, the fluffy, not really harem pants, but just the more
sort of like the parachute fitting pants.
Sort of Romani type pants that you would see more of the men wearing.
Something a bit more bohemian.
Exactly. Yeah. More bohemian. But the top is definitely like, it's a halter top, but it's made of like twisted fabric that's kind of twisted in the middle, but then spread out.
Over yeah, it's like,
looks like, yeah, like fabric chest wrap type thing to keep her boobage in place while she's whooping butt.
Yeah, that's pretty much what it is.
Okay.
It's pretty much what it is. Kind of a twisty, loopy fabric thing.
Yeah, I wanted to add in real quick. Basically, I'm going to pull a, you know, I'm going to let you finish, but... I wanted to.
Sorry, what was that?
Pass it by, man. Let it drop. One thing I forgot.
Everybody just talking at once. Damn it,
Kanye! How did you get in here?
Right. I'm gonna let you finish, but first,
I'm gonna let you finish.
I wanted to throw Zanya's description in there real quick before I forgot, because I will do that.
Oh, yeah.
And all of you guys will be like, Who are we looking for? I'll be like a ninja in the night.
From what I've gathered, though, from her miniature, she looks really tall and pretty. Very tall and pretty.
Thank you. She is about average height, though, but her horns, because they go kind of back and up a little bit, they add some height to her.
Yeah, add like an extra foot.
About almost. No, not quite that much, but yeah. Several. Well, no, actually, yeah. Anyway.
They're big.
Yeah. She is, from what you can see, she has a tendency to keep her face shadowed within a very deep hood. Granted, it's with the way her horns are, she can't exactly camouflage herself.
No, not really. It's a little hard.
Yeah. So the hood has, it's specially made so that it can slip, her horns can slip through it, but it hides
little
her face.
Horn holes in the top.
Yeah, exactly. Kind of like, the butt flap on those old pajamas. Just, oh my gosh.
The flap of my soul is down.
it's not that bad. But anyhow, from what people can see of her face, she has a sort of pale purple, almost like a lavender tint to her skin, and her hair is white. Some of it has escaped the hood, and it is like
the hood.
The hood.
Yo.
The hood.
Let her finish. So she can let you finish.
Yeah, sure.
Straight from the trap, yo. it is like stark white, like somebody has been severely traumatized white.
Oh no.
However, she wears lightweight fabric gloves over her hands at all times. When anybody has seen her, she's always had gloves on. She's always had this deep hooded cowl on. But aside from the faint purple skin that can be seen from underneath her hood, and the hair, perhaps a glint of her tiefling silver eyes, nobody has really seen a lot about her. She's that mysterious figure in the back corner of the tavern.
You saw nothing.
Right? People are both intrigued and very put off because she is a tiefling. But she reads the cards. So, and it is definitely a Harrow deck.
Yes, the Harrow deck.
Yes, it is definitely a Harrow deck. Anybody who's seen the cards can tell you that she will read the Harrow for you.
I think that Zanya and Dia have a lot to talk about.
Maybe.
Yeah, actually.
Maybe. We'll see.
I don't know if did I tell you this before? I actually the monk archetype that I chose for Dia is the Harrow Warden.
No shit, really?
Yeah.
That's cool. Ellie, you didn't hear that.
And
that was a grown up word. Don't say that.
Nah.
She's so quiet when she's playing her games. Did I forget she's there?
Well,
she's listening.
Aww.
She's 7 years old, guys. You know she is. Oh,
that's
Lord,
adorable.
Okay. Sis, yours?
Yes.
Yes. Mine.
The brevity. Shut the two chatters up.
Oh, my goodness.
You're going to have to interject or you're going to get trampled on, I feel.
No. Yeah, no, we wouldn't do that.
Hair flip. Obligatory hair flip of blonde hair.
Oh.
Shiny metal armor out of nowhere.
Oh, damn. She faints.
No, she's quiet. Well, I'm Maya. I decided to leave Chiliax because I disagreed with my very militant father.
Now, is this something that we would know if we asked somebody off the street about you?
She has no qualms about saying it.
Okay.
She's fine with it. It's just the details of it that she is kind of still hesitant to talk about.
Okay. I just didn't want you to feel like you had to go in. to right now.
That's okay. She's upset. So, you know.
She's going to be very vocal about some of it.
Yeah, she's going to be very vocal about some of her grievances, you know. But yeah, so I've decided to leave my hometown, I guess, my homeland, because I disagreed with what was going on there. And I decided to seek my fortune elsewhere. And now I'm a cleric. So I heal people. And I do midwifery sometimes. That's the extra coin.
Do you announce who you're a cleric of?
No, not yet.
Okay.
No. Okay. So you don't wear a symbol?
I might have to. No, well,
the symbol might be visible, but you would have to do a knowledge religion check to identify it if she's not announcing
it. Exactly.
And I know that that's definitely not something that my character would know because of her.
Yeah, it's gonna be questionable at best, but that's the most that she's gonna, you know, put out there. So that is it. The rest is up to chance and discovery, I guess.
Rock on.
Indeed.
Sounds awesome.
She's she looks simple, but you know, she's a woman of she's, I guess, conviction, like her own conviction.
I like
it. like she has that kind, she has that gentle face, I guess. Well, not super gentle, but you know, she's vocal at times, but when shit happens, she's like, she's either gonna panic or she's gonna go and rescue her friends. So
interesting.
Yeah,
she can either freak the F out.
She's gonna be like, fuck,
or go in like a wrecking ball.
Exactly. I love it. She's gonna be weird, but it's gonna be fun. Jesus,
a weird cleric. Awesome.
And you might find her speaking in tongues at times.
Oh dear.
So, yeah.
Oh yeah, we talked about that, didn't we?
That's gonna be cool.
Oh dear.
You're gonna have a crazy cleric.
Great. That's okay.
It's definitely okay.
This is gonna be like one heck of an interesting group.
This is
yes. Now, did any of you take any of the story traits?
I thought about it,
but I did not, you know.
Okay, so no one did.
Nope. I did.
Oh, you did?
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is it relating to the spot, the blot?
Oh, wait.
Yes, it's...
Okay.
Where is it?
Is that the one for the campaign? The campaign traits?
Yeah. The story traits.
Oh, okay.
Campaign traits.
I think I forgot to put it down. Oh, no, I didn't. It's right there. Into enemy territory.
Yeah, that's the one I have as well. I was about to say. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, that's the one I got. Oh, Matt. I got the feet, Matt. Yes, Matt.
Yes.
Okay.
sorry.
I got the feat that you suggested that I take.
Which one?
Selective channeling.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you for that, by the way. Yeah.
We need that big time.
No, you don't.
I got
the enemies love being healed.
Oh, yes. I'm sure they do. I'm sure they do. But we love being healed more.
All right. Strange days are afoot in Riddleport as an inexplicable shadow hovers in the sky over the city, attracting scholars and mystics to divine its meanings. Yet, for most of Riddleport citizens, the shadow significant, known locally as the Blot, is fleeting. Life continues on the streets of Riddleport and the local game tournaments held at the Gold Goblin Gambling Hall and other places continue unaffected. You find yourselves in Riddleport, wandering the streets, going about your business, whatever that might be.
Okay. Wow. I am actually preparing to join this event. I would like to speak to whoever is where was this going to be held again?
The Gold Goblin?
Yeah, the Gold Goblin. Okay. I would like to speak to the proprietor of the Gold Goblin and inquire about if I would be allowed to essentially read the tarot for people there at the event.
Okay. You head into the Gold Goblin. Standing before the main doors of the building is an 8-foot-tall statue cast in shining gold to resemble a larger-than-life goblin. It balances a golden It balances a golden dog slicer on a pile of gold as it smiles smugly down on all customers who pass beneath its gaze. The doors themselves are of a strong dark wood imported from southern lands and are decorated with multiple panels depicting signs of luck and good fortune, such as four-leaf clovers, crossed fingers, and so on. They can be locked from the inside, but they are currently open. There is a crowd here going in, and there are waitresses. From a distance, they appear to be tieflings. But as you get closer, you realize they're just dressed up as them. These are just human barmaids dressed as tieflings.
Huh.
It's Oktoberfest.
The casino floor is...
I'm making this lighthearted because I know we're both flustered, Dame, okay?
Yeah.
The casino floor is a wide room carpeted in rich red that has recently been patched in many places. Spread throughout the chamber are tables where different games are run. The floor hours are usually 12 p.m. to 3 a.m., though these are extended during the Cheat the Devil and Take His Gold tournament, which is coming up.
That sounds so fun.
A barmaid stops you at the door and holds out her hand and asks for a gold for entry.
And I hand over a gold. I give her a gold.
Okay, you are free to enter now.
All right.
You notice no one frisks you for weapons. No one has a check at the door for any sorts of weapons. As you look around, there's people carrying weapons openly. though no one seems to be getting into a fight by drawing them, there are fist fights going on and normal drunken brawls and whatnot, cheaters being accused, etc. No one ever draws a weapon. It is an unspoken rule here. You may carry, but you do not draw.
Wow. Very nice.
This seems like a perfect place for my halfling to be right now. just beating the crap out of people.
Right.
What's up?
Place full of brawlers who are openly duking it out. That's just her place. Yep. If you were there, I'd probably take you and like throw you in there. No, I'm kidding.
Banzai!
Does anybody seem to have a problem with the larger than normal sized raven perched on one of my horns?
No one
even mentions it.
Okay.
No.
Awesome.
No one really.
Yeah, I was asking the if there was an issue in the tavern because it's a bird and it's big.
I don't think anyone would.
Okay. Before the server leaves, I very gently take her elbow and ask who I would speak to about how would I phrase it? Well, essentially, I'm just going to be blunt. Who would I speak to about the possibility of reading cards for their patrons as extra entertainment?
Speak to Lara Felden. He's the floor manager.
Lara Felden?
Yes, it is spelled L-A-R-U-R-F-E-L-D-I-N. Lauerfelden.
Oh my, I forgot to have my tablet here. Oh my gosh. I was so excited to get into it, I completely forgot my tablet.
No worries.
I was like, woohoo, we're getting started.
I can...
Feldrum. Okay. Okay, I thank her in a quiet voice and then ask her, where would I find Master Feldrum?
She takes you to a area. Just a second. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to do three things at once at the moment.
Hey, that's all right. Take your time. You do what you gotta do.
Well, I'm pulling up the roll 20 and getting the area revealed where you guys actually are, or at least you are.
All right.
So give me a moment to trace out
the
visible.
I've actually got to get to the right page of my binder to write this stuff down. Now, if you guys hear too much background noise on my side, let me know, because my mic has to sit on my desk and it picks up like every single freaking vibration on this side of the world.
Hasn't been an issue yet.
Oh, fabulous. Okay. Just grateful I don't live in California, where I would have to deal with earthquakes, because that would be really noisy and inconvenient.
This is a very big area.
Ooh. So, Lar, he's the proprietor of the Golden Goblin?
Okay. That's the main floor and outside entrance. You should be able to see.
Oh, no. My D20 on the thingy hangouts isn't showing up. Hang on. Crap.
All I see is a black bit.
Okay.
Yeah. Do we actually have to log? Do we actually have to go to D20? We shouldn't have to, right?
No. Just a moment. I just need to set you guys to be on the Gold Goblin. I've got you in a different area.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that explains the fog of war black.
Yep.
Particular shade of black.
Yeah, exactly.
There we go.
Now, Lar is the proprietor?
Lar is the floor manager.
Floor manager, okay.
Yes.
I was about to say floor manager, okay.
Okay. And the room she takes you into is this one down here, which is also uncovered.
I can't see anything.
Okay, so as you enter.
I can't see anything.
Yeah, I know.
Really?
I'm seeing black as well.
Try scrolling the page around a little bit.
Okay, yep, I've been doing that.
Let me see. Whoops. Hang on. I've got...
Nope.
What's going on over here? Yeah, it's not showing up, but let me see. Hang on.
Maybe we have to join the actual...
I can see it on my screen, so not sure why you can't. Oh. We lost Dame.
Uh-oh.
On both. I think she might have refreshed.
Probably.
Yeah, because I put you guys as playing this area now.
That's weird. Yeah, I checked on Roll 20 and it's not showing either. So,
It is... About one, two, three, four, five, six spaces down and four or five spaces to the right from the top left corner is the start of the revealed area. It's a very large map. But you should be able to see it.
Yeah, I've... I don't know. I've zoomed in and out, and I can't scroll to the right for some reason, but only up and down.
Is there something else that we need to click on here? Let's see. No, we're in the right. All right, screen. Okay. Hmm. Well. Bollocks. Let me see.
This is
me.
Peculiar.
Yeah, it is peculiar.
Does that help?
If I described exactly what I see, would that help at all?
Maybe.
Because all I see is a giant white square, and part of it is black. Like the top the top left corner, and it extends to about the top middle.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all. That's black, and the rest is white.
Over on the right, there's a scale. Are you zoomed all the way out?
Yep. Zoomed in, zoomed mm-hmm. out, over and over and over.
Okay.
Yep.
Mm.
Maybe a visibility something or other, maybe?
Well, since that's not working, give me a moment and I will find another way to show you this.
Okay. What is it that we're missing that's causing this to happen? Gosh darn it.
Maybe a screen cap.
Well,
could work, maybe.
Okay. I'm just going to upload this to Obsidian Portal.
Is there maybe something under Roll 20 that something else we're missing? Because this shouldn't be happening. This should not be happening. This is... Oops.
Okay. We'll actually have a little bit more color and whatnot with this, so.
Okay. Ah!
Something finally there. Worked for you?
I see it now.
Wait, what? What's going on? What?
How'd you get it to work?
Me?
Yeah.
No, not on Roll 20. I see it on the Obsidian.
Oh, okay.
Page, yeah. On the Obsidian page that you...
Okay, I thought you got Roll 20 to work. I'm like, woo!
No.
where is this thing? Is it on maps? Or?
Yes, it is in maps. Yeah. It is called Gold Goblin Gambling Hall.
Oh, I see it. Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. It's so big.
Yes.
Yeah.
What the heck? It's a
big place.
There's a fountain, too.
Yes. Okay, so you have gone one, which is the outside, through two, which is the interior. She escorts you by area three, which is the cashier's nook.
Wait, hang on a second. I was trying to fix the D20 thing, trying to find a solution. Where is this map? I am so sorry.
Obsidian Portal.
Obsidian Portal.
It's an obsidian?
It's in maps.
Yes. Maps. Right there. Okay, yeah. Thank you. Sorry.
Oh, God, my... Ooh. Right. You guys can see it? You opened it up and it's loaded in?
Yeah, oh, God, this place is huge. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So you've gone through one and two. They take you over to three, which is the cashier's area. This foyer provides access to the cashier's counter, which is secured by a row of vertical bars set firmly into the stone floor.
Mm-hmm.
And then just to the right of that is the floor manager's office, and that's where they take you. This office is outfitted with an elaborate mahogany desk and a comfortable chair. Before the desk sits two more chairs of less comfortable design with manacles set into their arms. The walls are painted flat black, and a single candelabra provides only a dim light. The desk is covered in records and receipts from the day-to-day running of the establishment, and this chamber is likewise where Laura Feldren and a few of the guards sweat anyone caught or suspected of cheating the house.
Mm-hmm.
So you have been brought in here to talk to Laura about your proposal. This is Area 9 on the map.
Area...
Oh, okay. I was looking in the wrong direction. I was looking at 5.
Okay, I see. So 3 is sort of a, like, kind of a general POS sort of place, and then 9 would be, like, the manager's office.
3 is the cashier area. That's where you exchange your chips and money and, yeah.
Okay. Okay. So I'm just standing in front of him?
Yes. He motions for you to feel free to sit.
Okay.
But he seems to be busy with some paperwork at the moment.
Okay. I walk in confidently. And take a seat and pull the hem of my hood back a little bit so to be respectful so he can see my face.
Okay. He looks up and goes, "Oh, an actual tiefling. You here for a floor job?"
No, Master Feldren. I am actually a reader of cards, a fortune teller, if you will.
No, we don't let card counting happen here. I'm sorry.
Oh, no. Forgive me. You misunderstand. I am a fortune teller. I have my own deck of cards, and I read the fortunes for anybody curious about their fate. I was wondering if perhaps you might like to have some additional entertainment. For,
So you do want the floor job?
Well, yes. I suppose you would consider that a floor job. Yes.
Yes, quite. Yes.
Okay. You can tell he's a little confused at what's going on. First, you come in and you don't want the floor job, and then you do want the floor job. But you're talking about counting cards and having your own deck in a casino. He's not following you at all.
He's not familiar with fortune telling?
But not in a casino.
Not in a casino. Okay, that makes sense. But I clear my throat and sort of place a hand to my chest of this as if, you know, a demure lady is somewhat flustered. Master Feldren, I apologize for any confusion. I have not actually entertained individuals in a casino type of environment. It's so festive. It's a little flustering. I was just perhaps wondering if... Oh, gosh. How to work. End up getting kicked out of here on my head. Oh gosh, I don't know what to say to him so that his goons don't usher me out like immediately. Well, essentially, I tell fortunes, I was wondering if, well, perhaps this may not be the best idea after all. And I sort of put a hand to my forehead and sigh deeply.
Face palm.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. And?
I apologize for wasting your time. It has been an incredibly long day, which I'm sure that you absolutely understand because you look incredibly busy. I was just hoping that perhaps I could help your establishment bring in even a little bit more profit with some extra entertainment for those who may not be, testing their luck, perhaps.
Okay, go ahead and give me a diplomacy roll.
How do we do that? I'm so going to get thrown out on my butt. Okay, what do I roll? How do I do that?
It will be a d20, and then whatever your diplomacy bonus is from charisma and skill training, etc., you just add that to the roll result.
It's a d20?
Yes.
How do I... Wait, hang on.
There's this... if you're using roll d20, there's a bar on the side, the left side, that you can click on.
They'll have a 20-sided dice. It's, I think, the second one from the bottom.
Yep, second from the bottom.
Oh, it's not showing up.
See, I just rolled one. I got a horrible result of a 3.
Rolling 1d20. That's not showing up. I'm using the app for Google, and it's not showing up for me.
Yeah, that's what I just did.
Yeah, I know. It's not the... It's not showing up for me. Why is it not showing up for me? Let me see. Show macro quick bar. That didn't do anything. Type. Da, 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 da. Oh, come on. Really?
Dame, if you open the call and you see the little icons on the left, there's a... Like a dice-shaped.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have that open. I have the roll 20 thing open, but it's not showing me the dice.
The dice roller?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Yikes.
All sorts of technical issues.
Yeah. My finger's got to be a pain in the butt. Let's see.
Well, there's always wizards.
I don't need 3D dice. What is going on? Seriously? Okay, well that's all for macros. I'm not doing that.
No, it on the left.
Yeah, I know, honey. It's not there. I do not have any dice.
Okay.
I have nothing there.
The toolbar on the left, you've got at the very bottom a question mark. The icon right above that. You click that. That's the dice roller.
Okay. Hang on. Let me refresh this because I totally do not have a bar. All I have is the Google stuff. Give me just a second. Okay, guys. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Okie dokie.
Strange that it's not working. This is working for us fine, right?
Yeah.
I see it. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's okay. We'll get better as we go on.
Wait.
Mine's just got to be difficult, that's all.
Your roll, like...
No, we're having...
Furtive test roll, like, just registered on my screen.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I saw yours as well earlier.
Okay. All right, so I'm going to roll, and it's there now.
Okay, good.
Good.
Yeah. Yeah, now I've got it. Let's roll 1d20.
Beep. These dice don't like rolling.
I rolled a 5.
The pictures are, like, for example, Dame's, face is obscuring the rolls. I can't see it.
The result is a 5.
Yeah, I saw it as a 5.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh Lord.
That's okay. I was doing a crap job role playing that.
I kind of... I was hoping so hard.
I know. I didn't realize how in over my head I was gonna be, and
he was doing paperwork. You know.
Do you have any bonuses to your diplomacy?
I don't have any diplomacy.
no charisma bonus, even?
As a tiefling? Excuse me.
Looks like you've got a +1 charisma. Looking at your sheet.
So you're
so your total is a 6. No eggs. Yeah. Well done.
It's my bird. It's my bird. He throws everybody. Oh.
Caw!
In the middle of the
he looks up at you and goes, I honestly have no idea how that would work. Perhaps you can sell it to me better at another time. Or most likely after the big event. We can revisit it then, if you wish.
Yes. I thank you for your time. I am so sorry to have interrupted your important part.
And no worries.
I do my best to sort of adjust my ride back into its not-so-skewed place. Rise and make my way towards the exit.
In which I come in, because I've been outside for too long.
You didn't want to play any games while you were in? It did cost you a gold to come in. You might as well try to win it back, right?
No, I meant just leave the office.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Just walk out of the office and through the cashier place, because I don't need to be back there.
Well, unless you need some chips.
Well, not behind there, though.
No. Oh,
wait, is that space like...
Yeah, that's in front of the desk, yeah.
Oh, okay, so that little open area right in front of his office, people can actually be behind there.
Yes.
In that space.
Okay. Yeah, that's where you go up.
Dang map, though. There it is. Oh, I see, because four, that would be the actual place where the cashiers are.
Correct.
Inside that little area. Okay, so three is just, okay, I get it. All right. Okay, I stand outside of his office and sort of compose myself and take a deep breath. I'm not usually so put off by an encounter. And the bird on my horns just sort of croaks a very condescending chuckle at me. And I just kind of shake my head a little to sort of imbalance him a little bit. And then just sort of move into the crowd and just sort of walk around and observe at the moment.
Okay.
See what everybody's up to.
Among the normal games of like roulette and blackjack and poker, there are also four games here that you've not seen in any other casino ever before. They are Bounder, Goulette, Golem, and Skiffs.
Bounder, Goulette, Golem, and Skiffs?
Yes. These are all entered into the wiki on Obsidian Portal if you want to read up more about them. While you are doing that and deciding what you want to do here, Sis, you said Maya is entering in.
Yes, she's coming in. And she's gonna hand the not even just one gold. She's gonna hand five to whoever is at the door.
Ooh. Okay. They look at you blankly for a moment and then hand you back four gold.
I accept it. Thank you.
A profitable exchange.
Yeah, and then she just goes in and she observes. Wait. So. What's going on in the first floor? Like, what from what can I see from here? Like, what's going on at the moment?
Okay. The casino floor is a wide room carpeted in rich red that has been recently patched in many places. Spread throughout the chamber are tables where different games are run. The floor hours are usually noon to 3 a.m., though these are extended during the Cheat the Devil and Take His Gold tournament. Silken banners hang from the floor to the ceiling along the walls, and wide vertical blinds are drawn over the windows when morning light begins to peer in from the east. The chamber has a false ceiling 20 feet above, draped in layers of horizontally hung gauzy beige curtains. Light is provided by numerous chandeliers hanging below this false ceiling, as well as several large copper braziers spaced around the room with live coal to give the chamber a more hellish light for the tournament. At the back of the chamber, between the kitchen door, is a small dais bearing a bust of Desna, the goddess of luck.
Ooh. Okay.
Apart from the games I just mentioned to Dame, there is also a table where people are signing up for the Cheat the Devil and Take His Gold tournament. They approach, they hand over a bit of gold, and then they're handed a piece of paper, which then they sign and turn back in. You're observing this.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Hmm. Where did you say the dice was? Was it... What number is it on the map?
It is back by the kitchen, which is... which one? Number 12, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, so on that wall between those two doors, there's a dais of Desna.
Okay. Okay, first of all, Maya's just going to look up for a second and just gawk at everything because everything seems so pretty to her, even if it's in the hellish light. And then she...
Okay. While you're deciding, Matt, do you want to do anything?
Yeah, I think I'll walk in to the Gold Goblin Gambling Hall. You said that there are people, like, carrying weapons, and some people are, like, having, like, a drunken, like, a fist fight?
Yeah.
I think it would be perfect for Dia's character to just walk up and be like, may I have this dance, and then jump into the bar fight.